Today we're going to talk about the BLTouch on the MKS Gen version 1.4. I'm going to show you how to install this, but first I need to explain a couple things. Over here we have our servo pins. So there's three in a row and there's four rows of them. And inside that row you have the top section right here, which are signal pins. You have the middle section, which is our voltage, in this case 5 volts. And then you have the bottom section, which is ground. Now, the digital pins for the signal are digital pin 11, digital pin 6, 5, and 4. So we're going to use the connector with the three wires on it to connect to it. And those wires, the brown one over here is ground. The red one in the center is the voltage. And then the yellow is signal. In addition to that, we have to connect to our Z-min. So in order to do that, we need to know how to connect it. So inside here, there is some pins that say exactly what it is. They're written down below. It's kind of hard to read them, but I'll see if I can do it for you here. Oh, here we go. We have plus, which is voltage. Then we have minus, which is the ground pin in the center. And then at the very bottom, we have our signal pin, which is right here. So in order to do this, for this one, the white wire is signal, the black wire is ground. So in a moment, I'll show you how to connect it. Okay, to connect it's really simple. So all you have to do is line up the colors of the wires for signal, voltage, and ground, and then put them on pin 11 for the digital pin, which is over here. Next, we have to find the Z-min for our particular wires. So we're going to use the white and the black, and it's going to be on the outer edge, so it goes right there. So in a moment, I'll show you in Marlin how we're going to load the Marlin firmware. But before I can do that, I have to show you how to connect the USB. So the first thing that we need to do is connect the big side to the board. In order to do that, it's right over here. So you just push it right in. And then the other end I've already connected to the computer, so you're not going to hear a beep. But as you can see, the BLTouch has illuminated, which is good. And in a moment, we'll go into Marlin. Okay, in this folder we're going to open up the Marlin-bugfix-2.0.x. We're then going to open up the folder for there, and then the Marlin subfolder. Inside here we're going to go to source, and then we're going to go to core. Inside core we're going to open up boards.h. And inside boards.h, we're going to do a search on MKS. And as you can see, this is what we're looking for, which is board underscore MKS underscore gen underscore 13. And we're going to copy that. And then we're going to close out of here. We're going to go up a directory, then another directory. Then we're going to open up the marlin.ino. Okay, now we're going to go to the configuration.h tab, and we're going to do a search on motherboard. And what we're going to do is we're going to highlight board underscore ramps underscore 14 underscore EFB, and we're going to paste what we copied from the boards.h file. The next thing we want to do is we want to search on BLTouch. And as you can see, the BLTouch is commented out, so we're going to remove the comments by backspacing. And then we're going to scroll down, and as you can see, there's a millisecond delay of almost or just over a third of a second. For now, we're going to leave that alone, but you can experiment as you see fit. Then down below, we're going to search on num servo, so it's num underscore servo. And currently, it says that we have three servos. And it's also commented out, so we're going to remove the comment. We're going to scroll down and take a look around here. So currently, it has just under a third of a second for the time period. So in order to use three servos, we do comma 300, because there's three of them. But in this case, we only have one, so we're going to remove this. And we're going to change this to one. And then the next step is really simple. All you have to do is go over and find the Mega 2560 for the chipset or the processor, and then make sure that we have the COM port selected. So what we're going to do next is click the upload button, which will compile our changes and upload the firmware to the board. In a moment, I'll show you how to test the BLTouch in Pronterface. So here we go. Okay, we're opening up Pronterface. We're going to connect to the 3D printer for the MKS Gen 1.4. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to press the Z home in just a second, but I want to show you what the current status of the end stops are, which is M119, and then enter. And as you can see, these two are not connected, so they say triggered. But this one says open, so now I'm going to show you how to test it. So I'm going to press here and then show you. Okay, now that we've actuated it with our finger, we're going to test it again with M119 and press enter. And it says triggered. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe. And thank you for your time.